Welcome to my classroom. I am Nesli. In this video, I shall try to explain which ions and which ion channels are responsible for the formation of resting membrane potential in our cells. Consider two areas relatively close to each other. If negatively charged ions are higher in number in one and positively charged ions are higher in number in the other, then we talk about an electrical potential difference or a voltage difference between these two areas. In all cells of our body, there is a similar electrical potential difference between the two sides of the cell membrane. This is called resting membrane potential. During the resting membrane potential, in all cells of our body, inside of the membrane, the cell membrane has more negative charges compared to the outside. Until now, resting membrane potentials about from minus 80 millivolt to minus 200 millivolt have been measured. Membrane potentials are especially important for heart, muscle and nerve cells, because functioning of these cells depend on the electrical potentials, the membrane potentials. The resting membrane potential in these three types of cells have been recorded to be between minus 60 and minus 90 millivolts. We know that all potentials, membrane potentials in the body, are produced by ions, or ions carry the charges that produce these membrane potentials. So, the question is, which ion is responsible for the formation of resting membrane potential in these three types of cells? Heart cells, muscle cells, and nerve cells. The responsible ion is mainly potassium, and a little bit sodium is also involved. Now let us try to give some examples to understand this condition better. Here we have four cells. Some conditions are the same in these cells. What are they? The max potential of potassium is minus 80 millivolt. Max potential of sodium is plus 61 millivolt. And we all know that sodium is higher in concentration in outside the cells, and potassium is higher in concentration inside the cells. I do not even have to repeat this. Before going any further, I need to warn you that you need to have a good knowledge of nerve potential, or it would be better if you have watched the videos about the nerve potential for potassium and the nerve potential for sodium. So let us start. With these conditions, in the cell number one here, the resting membrane potential has been measured and it has found to be minus 80 millivolts, meaning that interior of the cell is 80 millivolts more negative compared to the outside. The resting membrane potential is always there. The cells do not start to produce it when we start measuring it. No, it has already been produced. But here, for the purposes of learning and teaching, I would like you to consider this question. Which ion channels would you like to put in the membrane of a cell with these nerve potentials to produce a resting membrane potential which is equal to minus 80 millivolts? And I am going to give you a hint. As I have explained in another video, any ion with a concentration difference, if this ion finds an open channel for itself, it will try to make the membrane potential equal to the nerve potential of that ion. So please turn off the video now and consider, if you were to produce this cell in the lab, which ion channels would you prefer to put on the cell membrane to get a resting membrane potential of minus 80 millivolt? Are you back? I hope you are back with the response that there are only channels, open channels for potassium on the membrane of this cell. So the potassium concentration difference, potassium being higher inside, working through the ion channels, potassium channels, has brought the membrane potential at rest for this cell to minus 80 millivolt. Let us go on to the next cell. In the next cell, I have measured the resting membrane potential as plus 61 millivolt, which means that interior of the cell membrane carries more positive charges. So, please remember that the resting membrane potential is always there. I want you to think, if you were to produce a resting membrane potential which is equal to plus 61, which ion channels would you prefer to put on the membrane of this cell? Or which ion channels were there in the membrane of the cell and they have produced a resting membrane potential of plus 61 millivolt? Please stop the video and think about it. I know you are back with the answer that there are only open channels for sodium ion on the membrane of this cell. If you are back with this answer, you are right. So, sodium being high outside the cell has a force and an effect so that it is combined with the open sodium channels at rest, and this has produced a resting membrane potential of plus 61 millivolt. But very important to say, before going any further, I must tell you that this was just an exercise. I wanted you to consider different cells, but a cell with a positive resting membrane potential is not present in the body. Now let us move on to the third and the fourth cells. On the third cell, the resting membrane potential was measured to be 75 millivolts interior, being more negative compared to the outside. Think about it. Every ion will try to move the membrane potential, the resting membrane potential, toward its own next. If it was only for potassium, potassium would try to make it equal to minus 80. If we only had sodium open channels for sodium, these would try to bring the membrane potential to plus 61. But it is neither of them. So please stop the video once more and consider, try to give an answer, which type of open ion channels are present on the membrane of this cell. I know you are back with the information that there is a lot of open potassium channels on the membrane of the cell, and there are a few open sodium channels on the membrane of this cell. So each of the ions will try to pull the resting membrane potential towards its nest, but because potassium has greater number of ion channels, the membrane potential, the resting membrane potential, is closer to the nest potential of potassium, although it's not equal to it because of the effect of the few sodium channels. Now let's move on to the last cell, the fourth cell. Here, the resting membrane potential is minus 70 millivolt. Which channels do you think are present on the membrane of this cell? I'm sure you're going to say that there is a lot of potassium channels and there is some sodium channels present on the membrane of this cell. But then I should ask, what is the difference of the third cell from the fourth cell in this case? At this point, we can talk about conductance, which is expressed by G. So, if a substance, the passage of a substance through the cell membrane is known as permeability. If a substance is able to pass the cell membrane, we say the cell membrane is permeable to it. But this is about matter. Our ions are matter, but at the same time they carry an electrical charge. So we can also use the word conductance for these ions. So the more ion channels there are, the greater will be the conductance of the cell membrane to that ion. So if we can compare the conductance to potassium and sodium in cell number 3, what can we say? Potassium conductance is bigger than sodium conductance in cell number 3. And we can say the same thing for the cell number 4. Potassium conductance is bigger than the sodium conductance. But what is the difference between these two cells? We can find it out by looking at the sodium conductances. To express this difference, we use the ratio of conductance for sodium to the conductance for potassium. What can we say here? In which cell has a bigger G sodium to G potassium ratio? The answer is that the cell number 4 has a bigger sodium to potassium ratio, and the cell number 2 has a smaller sodium to potassium conductance ratio. So we can see that the cell membrane is going toward less negative values. Resting membrane potential becomes less and less negative if a cell has greater and greater amounts of sodium conductance. So in this video, I tried to explain that potassium is the main ion that determines the membrane potential in muscle, heart, and nerve cells. And in some or many of the cells, there is also a contribution of sodium. But the main ion is potassium. Thank you for watching. I hope it has been useful.